This clip will present the interface and usability enhancements made to the IFC translation setup dialog in ARCHICAD 19. Several enhancements to the IFC translation setup function have been implemented in ARCHICAD 19. The first is the Create New button in the upper right corner of the dialog. Click this button to create a new IFC translator. In the upcoming dialog, provide a name for it and click the Save button. As a result, a new IFC translator will be created based on the settings of the general translator. In ARCHICAD 19, you can now set a Use For status for translators. Select any of the IFC translators in the list and click the right-pointing arrow button in the Use For column. You have three possible choices. You can set the given IFC translator to be used for import only, for export only, or for both export and import. As a result, the translator will be displayed among available translators only in the type of data exchange process dialogs it was enabled to be used in. For example, the Import from Modeling Applications translator is set to Use for Import. So it's available only in the dialog of import processes, such as Open and Merge. And it's not available at export processes, such as Save As. This column has another effect. If a translator status is set to be used for export only or import only, those settings panels and options that are not relevant for the status will become grayed and inactive. In the case of the Import from Modeling Applications translator that was set to Use for Import, the Export Options panel becomes grayed since its settings have no effect on import processes. It's a good practice to set this field properly for each translator, because the list of translators is more manageable in dialogues when only relevant translators are listed. This is becoming increasingly true since more and more translators are added from ARCHICAD's collaboration with an increasing number of applications using the open source IFC file format. When you've set which translators are used for export and import, you can also select which translator will be used as the default in export dialogs and in import dialogs by setting the defaults column accordingly. Lastly, it's possible to sort the list of translators by either of these columns as well by clicking in their column title.